my lover cut off my leg, and I was in a trash can, and the main character, me, said that I was hungry. Hey guys, gals, and non-binary pals. This is me, June, and we're back with another episode of Oddly Specific, where I talk about the minute details of the media I enjoy. Today, I really want to cover dating sims. Dating sims are considered a casual genre of game, but I'm not a casual dating sim player. I play them aggressively, like much to the point where I've gotten into arguments with people about dating sims, not necessarily about the content of them, just them as a genre in general. So I think that qualifies me as being a non-normal player of dating sims. I think I started playing them probably in middle school, which is like when anyone starts playing dating sims, because I was like lonely and 12, and like the only guy I liked was this dude who told me to my face he'd rather watch his family burn to death than kiss me. So I turned to the internet to get people to love me, which, you know, is sad and kind of pathetic, but that's what I did. And I guess dating sims really appealed to me because, like, they have what romance novels just can't do. They have a whole bunch of, like, it's just such an interesting medium of game. So dating sims are visual novels, and the whole objective, of course, is to date someone. And there are, I've played enough to know there are several types of dating sims. You can have ones that are more like, it's basically the same story no matter who you go for, and there's a prologue, and the story only really changes based on maybe one or two moments you have your romantic interest. Those are games like Hustle Cat, you know, or there's games that are really more like, really broad, and you have to gain things like affection points, and you go on dates, and you have to like earn the right to call someone your romantic partner in these games. So those are games more like XOXO Droplets or Dandelion Wishes Brought to You, like games like that that are just in death, and you're basically scrubbing to earn stats or skill points or something to get these people to like you. And specifically, I wanted to talk about Dandelion Wishes Brought to You because I was thinking about it earlier, and I was thinking about it when I said that today I want to talk about dating sims, because that game was fucking weird. All dating sims are weird. That's what people don't seem to understand. Like, when dating sims started to become big with some of my friends who don't usually play dating sims, like with like when Dream Daddy came out, and everyone was so excited because Dream Daddy was like LGBT positive. But like, visual novels in general have been very good for the LGBT community. A lot of people who make visual novels tend to be, visual novels a lot of times that I found tend to be for and by people of the LGBT community. So like, while I enjoyed Dream Daddy, it wasn't really like groundbreaking for a dating sim to be about gay dads dating. Like, I've played maybe about 14 of those types of games before Dream Daddy and after it, which is not hating on it. It's a good game, but it's just like, it's one of those games that brought dating sims to groups of people who don't usually play dating sims. And I would get into arguments with people about it because there was that secret ending in Dream Daddy that was apparently really fucked up, and people were like, how could this have happened? Why would they let this in? How damaging? And it's like, all dating sims have one really fucked up ending, or a couple really fucked up endings. Of course, the object of them is romance, but like, the thing with them also, it's so far, most of them are just so far from what counts as realistic romance that they can get away with anything. So Dandelion, for those who have not played Dandelion, the story is you are Hee-jung, who is a young woman living in South Korea. She lives in Busan. She moved away from her family, her mom specifically, because they have some family troubles. She doesn't really like her mom. Her mom's too strict on her. And, you know, Hee-jung doesn't want all that stress that her mom gives her. She just wants to be an artist. She wants to live by herself. And she moves to Busan to go to, Busan, to go to university. And she's kind of lonely. She only has like one friend. And the story is one day she wakes up and there are two cats and three rabbits in a basket by her bed. Now, unbeknownst to her, in a couple of weeks, months, those cats and rabbits are gonna turn into hot, hot men that she will be able to date and maybe fuck. That's the story. If I read that on the back of a book, I would burn that book in like the biggest trash fire. But as a game, that's like, yes, I can't wait for these cats and rabbits to turn into human men. I can't wait to date a cat. Like, that's the entire object of the game. And that game, well, first of all, I think it took too long for the cats and rabbits to turn into men. Because when you play that game, it's basically like the first couple of months as you hanging out with your cat or hanging out with your rabbit, earning affection points with your cat and rabbit, taking your cat and rabbit out on dates. You know how fucking weird it is to take your cat on a goddamn date, go to the park with it, your cat or your rabbit, you're trying to hang out, have a picnic with your fucking pet, and then a butterfly starts flirting with your rabbit so you have to leave? That's the kind of shit you put up with in Dandelion. But like, the opening part of that story, the reason why they're like animals for so long is you gain affection points with them, and then at a certain time in the story, when you have enough and when a certain amount of time has gone by, they will all turn into humans. And the story is that these cats and rabbit men are from a different dimension where people have cat ears and bunny ears and magical powers, and they're there to play a game that has been orchestrated by the wizard, who has been watching Heejung for a very long time and just likes to see her suffer. So he just sent a bunch of hot men to live with her and see which one she could fall in love with in this game, where the one she falls in love with gets their wishes granted. But when they fall in love and the wish is granted, they like go back to their own world and never see each other again, which is the entire story. That's Dandelion. But like, some parts of that story get really, really, really weird. Like, let's talk about Jisoo, who is one of the romantic options in that game. He's the black cat. He turns into a boy, and he's kind of like the bad boy. Like, that's his type. He's the bad boy. He, you know, he's kind of goofy in some ways. Like, he has his quirks. Like, he likes to eat a lot. He likes to shop. But he's definitely the bad guy. He, like, wears red and black. He, you know, he likes girls, and his whole thing is his root is he's the jealous type. He doesn't like you talking to other boys. He doesn't like you wearing skirts around other boys. He doesn't like knowing that you're hanging out with your guy friends without telling him, much to the point where in his normal root, whether or not you're getting the good ending or the bad ending, just in the normal story, Heejung's hanging out with a friend who happens to be a boy. Jisoo finds out about it, goes to the restaurant where she's innocently hanging out with this guy, bangs on the window, nearly attacks her friend, and drags her out of the restaurant. That is not a man you want to date in real life. That is not an acceptable behavior. If I read that in a book, I would scream about it. However, dating sims tend to get away with it. Because not even that, like, they're aware that this relationship isn't ideal. Like, maybe they're not. Maybe the writers were like, yeah, this guy's fucking hot. But also because, like, no, I guess it gets away with it because those are the types. Usually in dating sims, you get the one really, really, like, illegally jealous guy, like, basically your stalker, and you get, like, you get certain types in dating sims, and you kind of expect that. You expect one of your dating options to be kind of weird, depending on where the game's coming from. Like, I've played lots of dating sims that don't have that at all, but, like, for games like Dandelion, you kind of expect there to be these archetypes, and some of them are a little less healthy. So Jisoo is really the jealous and possessive type. And his bad ending is he drugs Heejung, makes it so she can't go to school and leave him, breaks her phone, and then, like, we don't know what happens after that. She's just drugged and in her bed, and he's made it so all the other guys aren't in the house anymore, and he's, like, her keeper now. And that's, like, yeah, it's a bad ending, but that's, like, pretty tame compared to some of the bad endings I've got. By the same people who made Dandelion, there's this game called Nameless, and like two of those routes get really, really strange. So Nameless is a story similar to Dandelion in the fact that it's about things that aren't human boys becoming human boys, but in Nameless, it's these ball joint dolls that the main character has that I don't ever remember why or if it ever tells you why they become men, but they do. And basically, one of them named Tay, he has like scars. He has scars from when he was a doll. And when you get into a relationship with him, the only way he can express himself is by scarring the main character or like inflicting pain on her. And like, this is just the normal route. Whether or not you get the good or bad ending with Tay, he will physically abuse the main character, and there's nothing you can do about it. It's just something he will do. Now, in the bad ending, he will literally turn her into a doll and you keep hurting her. In the good ending, he gets over this part of himself and he learns to not do this. So like, that's just the thing with the game. It's like, even in the normal ending, even in the normal just route, Jisoo's going to stalk you. Jisoo's gonna be wildly jealous. Jisoo's gonna threaten to attack guys you're friends with. In the normal game, Tay's going to abuse you, Tay's going to hurt you, Tay's going to be mean, and then you'll get to the good or bad ending. That's just like kind of how these games are. Like, I never really doubt, I like understand that these aren't healthy portrayals of relationships, and if there's a man like that in the real world, run away from him. But like, in a dating sim, I expect it. Like, I go into it knowing that something bad is going to happen to the main character, and it might be the cause of one of these guys. And like, a lot of people have taken like liberties with this. Like, some like people have really taken the dating sim, the visual novel genre, and really been trying to like up its ante, because it's, again, it's one of those genres that it's like a casual game. So now a lot of people take it seriously. Like, people are starting to use dating sim format and the visual novel format to disguise horror games, like Doki Doki Literature Club looks like a cutesy dating sim where you date these cute girls, but it turned out to be a pretty traumatic horror game. Like, it's pretty, I've heard it's pretty scary. And then there are games like Dead Wishes, which I played recently with a friend, where it's horror and romance, where basically the entire like thing of the game is like, the roots always start normal, but there's always something fucked up. Like, that game went from watching someone get murdered and having their face cut off and like thrown into a pile of other faces that my love interest had cut off, to my love interest in a different route cutting off my legs, both of them, and then making me eat one of my legs after I had been in a trash can kind of like dying for a little bit. Like, these are just the kind of things you expect from dating sims. I would never accept that, I think. And a game, like, if I had not known going into those games that these games are just kind of weird, it'd be kind of, like, traumatizing. Like, I did gag when I played Dead Wishes and my lover cut off my leg and I was in a trash can and the main character, me, said that I was hungry, and so he threw my leg that was rotting into the trash can and expected the main character to eat it. Yeah, that is horrifically disgusting. That's very graphic, and that is a true horror scenario, but I expect it from weird dating sims. And so it's just kind of something that I'm like, yeah, of course that's going to happen in a dating sim. There are so many weird dating sims out there. Like, we didn't bat our eyelashes to the one dating sim where the like entire like thing of the game is that you're dating pigeons, and in one of those routes, like, the pigeon, the doctor one, kills your friend, feeds him to you, and then in the end cuts off your head and keeps it. Like, that's just like so tame and so normal. So when people come at me and it's like, this dating sim is not like other dating sims, it's pretty niche, it's weird, it's all about murder and stuff, I'm like, yeah, a lot of them are. It's really not that strange for a dating sim to pull away from the whole cutesy romantic side, because there's basically those two. There are really, really cute, like, wholesome romantic dating sims. Dating sims are like my favorite games, like Hustle Cat is really cute and romantic, XOXO Droplets is really cute and romantic, except for the fact that, you know, all the characters in that game are jerks, but that's how it's being sold. It's like, all these characters are assholes, but at least they're not killing you. Hustle Cat is a really cute, wholesome game. You know, none of those characters will physically hurt you or abuse you, but then there's also the weird side of dating sims where it's like, yeah, you're gonna get your leg cut off. Yeah, you're gonna be put into a cage at certain points. Yeah, you're gonna just be, like, abused. Those are the two options you get with those games. Those are what you kind of expect. You get, you either go for the really, really cute stuff, or you go for the really, really fucked up stuff. True dating sim fans have just all accepted this, and it's not something I see a problem with, but it's also not something I would accept from if I was reading a romance novel or just any other game that wasn't a dating sim, which is, you know, why it's probably one of my favorite mediums, because it's like, it's just, it's an interesting way of storytelling, it's an interesting way of exploring these archetypes of characters, and it's just, it's a lot of fun, really. Like, the last dating sim I played, me and my friend, the entire storyline was the main character is trying to be a wizard, wizards need to get power from demons, and the only way wizards and demons exchange power is through sex. That's the entire story of the dating sim, and you have sex with demons. That's it. Would I accept that in literally any other form of storytelling as being top-notch basis for, like, yeah, that's it? No, I would not. Can I do that in a dating sim? Of course. So, that's why those games rock. Just before I stop, speaking of dating sims, actually, I once attempted to make a dating sim based off my book. Still, you know, chugging through that, but mostly I'm trying to segue into the fact that I'm also a Wattpad author, and recently my book reached 100,000 reads, which is a pretty big deal to me, and I made a whole video about it. And you should watch it, even if you're not interested in my book, because I say a couple things that might hint at a giveaway of stickers and possibly t-shirts, which might be pretty cool. It has a pretty sick design on it. So help me celebrate 100,000 reads, and I'll see you next time on another episode of Oddly Specific.